Hey YouTube, it's your girl Michelle, back with my second review for my Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation Concealer. Isn't this hair slayed? Yes. Yes. Hair is slayed. I'm going to find a link to this wig. This wig I've had for a couple months. It's, I don't know if you can see it. It's the Elva wig. I forgot who it's made by, but I will find it and link it in the description bar below. This wig is fierce and everything. I used to wear my hair like this, but I let it grow out. So I didn't want to cut it back off. And it takes forever for this hairstyle to grow out. Never, ever, ever do this unless you have patience. So I didn't want to cut my hair back off in a mohawk, so I bought a wig that looks like a mohawk. So I will link it below in the description bar, but let's get to the point of this video. In my previous video, I did tell you that this makeup did cover all my spots, which as you can see, yes, this face is slayed and beat. Check them eyebrows out today. They're snatched to the gods, honey, to the gods. But back to this, I did tell you in my previous video that it did cover all my spots and everything. Okay, my three pros, and I'm going to list my three cons of this product. My first pro that I really love is it covers everything. It gives me a matte finish at least for 8 hours of the day. Two, it conceals as well, so it conceals even if my under eyes when I wake up and I have bags and circles, all that is concealed. Three, it actually, as a drugstore makeup, matches my skin. I do not have to mix with another makeup, so that would be my pros. My cons would be, one, if you do not set it with a finishing spray, such as a Max, or a Maybelline or Urban Decay face setting spray after you put your makeup on, it becomes very oily and it transfers. Kind of like that Fashion Fair souffle that everybody used to use back in the day. Your grandma used to use to get it all on your shirt collar, anything you touched, it was on there. My second con would be, I notice in my T-zone when I start turning oily, it runs. Like, I can literally feel it running just a little bit, and I got to get a paper towel or something in the blotter or put on some blotting spray or to put on some blotting powder. Not blotting spray, spray, my bad. And my third one would be, it is thicker than my NARS. It transfers. It does transfer because I do talk on the phone at work and it is on the phone when I take the phone off. But for $8, what I did pay for this makeup, I would highly recommend it if you're on a budget. This is one of the best drugstore makes I have tried so far. So I would recommend this to you. I would pretty much say, you know, like, my face is laid. I mean, even with my highlight, it looks like my expensive makeup. I would give this 2 thumbs up because, ooh, wee. Yes, I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I finally found something. I will, however, be trying other foundations because I just want to see what's out there because I have always bought high-end foundations. I started off with Clinique, then I went to MAC. Then I went to some other junk. Then I went back to MAC. And now I'm on NARS. And I just go back and forth depending on who's got what out at the point of time. But I did want to try for everyday makeup because I do work. I wanted to try just because I didn't want to wear my NARS all the time because NARS, however, is expensive. I wanted to try to see what would be comparable for the days that I don't wear my NARS makeup. So, like I said, I really love this makeup. I would recommend it. It even colors with and blends with my neck. I didn't have to blend it down. I don't know if, as you can see, it's blended all in here really good and everything. Oh my God, I can't stop touching this hair. I love it. This is a wig I've had, and I have only worn it one time, and I forgot how cute it was, but I really love this hair. It's just slayed to the gods. Also, I did put on a little concealer today underneath my eyes because I was just playing in my makeup. So with this makeup, you don't have to put a concealer on, not unless you want to. Again, that is a repeat, unless you want to, because it is thick enough to cover all your areas. I would recommend this makeup as a go-to everyday makeup because of the fact you don't have to put a concealer on. You can just go out the door with it. Just, you know, a little gloss, throw your eyebrows on, even if you don't want to put on eyeshadow, just a little mascara, and you can go out the door. You don't have to conceal and everything versus other makeup. Some of them you do have to conceal if you choose to conceal. So that is, well, I'll add that as my fourth pro. So, yeah, I think that's about it. Like I said, I'll link the description if I can find this wig in the description bar. Color 09 tan in this, so y'all go check this out. I really love this makeup. So this is a buy. This is a good buy. You know, so check it out. See you guys later. Bye.